Knee replacement surgery is a surgical procedure designed to replace the damaged load-bearing surfaces of the knee joint. The most common cause of this damage is osteoarthritis. The main symptom of osteoarthritis is pain. Pain that starts to limit people's day-to-day activities, limit their walking distance, and eventually pain at night. Even when turning over in bed, it can wake them up and affect their sleep, such that eventually it significantly affects the quality of their life and limits their day-to-day activities. Knee replacement surgery is done under anaesthetic, and that can be either a general anaesthetic where the patient's asleep, or a spinal anaesthetic where a patient can be awake and may then have some sedation. The procedure takes about an hour and a half in total to undertake, and most patients are in hospital 3 to 4 days. So, to give you an idea of what a knee replacement actually means in practice from a surgical point of view, this is a model of a normal knee joint. This being the front, the patella, the femur, and the tibia. Now, a knee replacement isn't actually replacing the entire joint, but it's actually a resurfacing operation. So, if we take this model of a knee replacement here, you can see that if I remove the component, the knee joint is largely there, but the surfaces, the arthritic surfaces, have been removed and then resurfaced with either metal, as you can see here on the femoral side, or a combination of metal and plastic on the tibial side. And those are replaced into the knee to cover the worn out surfaces. The knee is then balanced nicely so the knee can move in as normal a way as possible without causing the arthritic pain. A knee replacement itself is made of a metal alloy, which is a combination of metals, and there's a plastic bearing. This is called ultra high molecular weight polyethylene, but plastic for short. It's a very wear resistant material. Because part of the prosthesis is metal, going through airports, for example, can actually set off the alarms. Having said that, millions of people have hip and knee replacements, so most airport authorities are very used to people walking through with joint replacements. The benefits of knee replacement surgery are to alleviate pain and improve function. And to give you an example of this, a lot of my patients might play golf and they start to become limited in their ability to do so. Instead of playing 18 holes, they tend to play 9 holes and then start using a buggy because their knee is too painful to walk any distance. Now, for most of my patients after knee replacement surgery, they're usually back on the golf course by about 12 weeks post-surgery and continue to improve for a year afterwards. So the outcomes are generally very good. Likewise, some of my patients are more active, like to play doubles tennis or even ski, and they're enabled to do so following their knee replacement surgery. The timing of knee replacement surgery is actually very individual. It very much depends on how much that person's knee pain is limiting their quality of life and how much the pain is affecting them. Some people may cope very well with a degree of pain because their activities are very limited. Other people are very active and have high demands and would perhaps move to knee replacement surgery a little earlier. But the main indication is to alleviate arthritic pain. There are risks to knee replacement surgery, but fortunately they're very small. The main risks include infection, thrombosis, stiffness, damage to nerves and vessels. Persistent pain can be a problem in a small percentage of people. Having said that, the risks are actually very small. For instance, the risk of infection is less than 1%. The main problem we actually see is stiffness, and people have to work very hard to regain range of movement and function after their surgical procedure. And that involves extensive physiotherapy. But the outcomes are still, on the whole, very good. Most patients who have knee replacement surgery in hospital for 3 or 4 days. If they were to have their knee replacement in the morning, we would expect that the physiotherapist would be getting them out of bed and start walking that afternoon. That has changed a lot over the last 10 years, such that 10 years ago the average inpatient stay was 10 to 11 days, and now it's 3 to 4 days on average. So our aim is to mobilise people quickly. The advantage of that is that it helps their rehabilitation, but also reduces risks of things such as deep vein thrombosis. One can't say how long an individual knee replacement may last, but we can refer to long-term follow-up studies to give us a guide as to how long it will do so. For instance, a lot of big studies now show that at 10 years, 97% of knee replacements are still working satisfactorily, and at 20 years, almost 90%. There are 30-year results, although they're relatively small, but suffice to say, we can assume that most knee replacements will last between 20 and 30 years.